Welcome everyone to an NCAA.com and March Madness Bracket Breakdown. I'm Andy Katz. This is our last bracket in advance of Champ Week. We will have another bracket on Selection Sunday. Let's take a look at what we did here at March Madness. First, let's go over the top four seeds in each region, and then a couple other nuggets about the bracket. Let's start in the loaded Midwest. One seed Kansas, one seed overall. Two seed Kentucky. 3 seed Villanova, 4 seed Louisville. Loaded. The Midwest would play the East. Dayton as the 1, Creighton as the 2, Maryland as the 3, Duke as the 4. As good as I think Dayton and Creighton are, they've earned those seeds. Maryland and Duke have not earned higher seeds, but I think they would take that bracket in the East. Out West, the West would play the South. Same kind of thing, I think. The bottom 3 and 4, similar to the East in the West. Gonzaga 1, San Diego State 2, Michigan State 3, Oregon 4. I think Michigan State would definitely take that bracket out West. In the South, Baylor 1, Florida State 2, Seton Hall 3, and Wisconsin 4. So clearly, the Midwest would be by far the most loaded bracket. Overall, 10 Big Ten teams, 7 out of the Big East, 7 out of the Pac-12. All 4 Final Four teams from last season, Virginia, Michigan State, Texas Tech, and Auburn, are in this field. The last 4 in the field, the 4 teams that we'd be playing in Dayton, Texas Tech and UCLA, Xavier, and Richmond. The first 4 out, Wichita State, NC State, Mississippi State, and I think the committee still should consider Northern Iowa, but because of the margin of defeat to Drake, that was in the quarterfinals, and upon further review, not even getting to the semis, ultimately Bradley won the Valley. It's going to be extremely difficult for Northern Iowa to get there, even though they won the regular season. So a really tough postseason tournament for the Panthers because they had such a great regular season. A.J. Green, the player of the year in the conference. So very interesting developments that have happened with this bracket over the course of this past week. I think the bubble is really shrinking. We'll see if there's other bid stealers out there in some of these major conferences that could knock off some of those last 4 teams in the field. But right now, the Midwest would be by far the most loaded bracket, and kind of hard to make an argument of which one would be second, but I think we are going to get a situation where the 3 and 4s are maybe the better brand names, but just didn't earn that 1 or 2.